أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My brothers and sisters, it is from the favor of Allah upon us that He subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a place to stay. He has made the earth subservient to us, a place of peace and rest and comfort, a place of enjoyment, a place of beauty, a place of joy, a place of recognizing Allah and using His favors properly. My brothers and sisters, part of this favor that Allah has given to us is that He has made roads and channels and walkways for us to move on this earth that He has created for us. Allah says in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ شَامِخَاتٍ وَأَسْقَيْنَاكُمْ مَاءً فُرَاتًا. He has given us transportation, that he has created some of them Himself that we can use as transportation. And some of the transportation that we use, we have made with our own hands, with the intellect that He has given us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of this is a sign for us. All of this is a lesson for us. And all of it for us now, for the believer who ponders and truly wants to thank Allah, must use it properly. Allah says in the Quran, لِتَسْتَوُوا عَلَى ذُهُورِهِ ثُمَّ تَذْكَرُوا نِعْمَةً رَبِّكُمْ إِذَا اسْتَوَيْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ وَتَقُولُوا سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَنَا هَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لَهُ مُقْرِنِينَ. Allah has given this to us, and we had no power or might to make it ourselves. وَإِنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. And to Allah will be our returning, meaning with Allah, we will be questioned for those favors. My brothers and sisters, on this earth, we have man, we have plants, and we have animals, and all of this is from the seen. But we have also things that live here on this planet are from the unseen, the jinn and the shayateen. And then on a daily basis, Allah also describes to us that we have another creation that visits our planet but doesn't actually live here. And they are the angels. Allah says, كُلَّوْ كَانَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَمْشُونَ مُتْمَئِنِّينَ لَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَكًا رَسُولًا. If this was a place where angels would settle, Allah would have sent an angel as a messenger. However, the angels do not settle. The angels walk this earth. But Allah describes to us, and this is a very important point, Allah describes to us how all three of these creations, how all three of these creations travel the earth of Allah. How man travels, how jinn and the shayateen travel, and how the angels travel. What purpose do they travel for, and the manner of them doing so. So Allah says about the angels, وَالذَّارِيَاتِ ذَرْوَى, the angels as they glide. فَالْحَامِلَاتِ وِقْرَى, and the only reason why they come down on earth, these angels, is to order, is to fulfill a very heavy order and command from their Lord, Jalla wa'ala. فَالجَّارِيَاتِ يُسْرَى, and they float on this earth with ease. فَالْمُقَسِّمَاتِ أَمْرَى, and each one of those angels has a prescribed and a separate command and objective whilst they traverse the earth. And Allah also describes the shayateen from the man and the jinn, how they travel and what purpose they travel for. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى سَعَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُفْسِدَ فِيهَا, when they turn and they move on the earth, their only objective is to move from one place to another, is to cause corruption. And whilst they move, they want to cause corruption. And their objective is to cause corruption. وَيُهْلِكَ الْحَرْثَ وَالنَّسَلُ, and they want to destroy everything that is in their path. وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَسَادُ, and Allah does not like corruption. Imam Ibn Jarir al-Tabari rahimahullah said in the tafsir of these ayat, there are people who want to spread harm on earth. They cut the pathways and the roadways. والإفساد السبيل على عباد الله, and they want to stop any kind of goodness spreading on earth. This is how they are, my brothers and sisters, may Allah rectify us. When they walk on the land, their only purpose is to spread corruption. When they drive on their land, their purpose is only to think about themselves. But how about the people of Iman? May Allah make us of them. What does Allah say about describing the people of Iman, and how do they walk on the earth? Do we have a description for that also? Of course we do. Allah has described the angels. Allah has described the shayateen. And about His servants, He says, جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. We have seen how Allah compares different creations. And we have seen how Allah talks about the objective of the shayateen when they walk across the earth. And none of that is beloved to Allah. But the slaves of Rahman, the slaves of Rahman, those who Allah loves, those who Allah accepts, those who Allah has actually called them as being His slave, when they walk on the earth, when they are in their cars, when they are traveling by train or on the bus, when they are using a bike, when they are getting a lift with somebody else, they have been described on moving on earth with humility. They have been described with the objective of spreading peace and goodness. And they do it with the intent of being nice to other people and being thoughtful of other people. And if they see badness and they meet badness, وَإِذَا خَاطَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا, if they see badness, if they hear badness, Imam Sa'di rahimahullah says, they are free from sin themselves. When they move from one place to another, they are free from sin themselves. They do not engage in ignorance, and they do not engage in bad behavior whilst transporting from one part to another. And Allah praises them for that, for the way they move from one area to another. But when they see bad themselves, they repel the bad from happening to the best of their ability. My brothers and sisters, may Allah make us of the followers of this religion. We have plenty of description of how the Prophet ﷺ himself used to walk the earth. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma described him moving in Medina like he was a cooled wind on a hot day. Others from the companions said it was as if the earth used to roll up underneath him because of the humility that he used to walk with. Others from the companions said that he used to walk as if he was walking down a slope. His head was down and he walked with a purpose. He didn't walk by wandering around like he was lost. He walked with a purpose and an objective. But in the final Hajj, my brothers and sisters, we actually have a command from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on how to walk and what manner to walk in, and even how fast to transport ourselves on earth. The Prophet ﷺ said during the final Hajj, Alaykum bis sakina, move on earth smoothly and calmly. Do not create difficulty, do not create congestion. For innal birr, he said, it is not from piety, laysa bil ida, it is not from piety, it is not from goodness that when a person walks on the earth, when he drives on the earth, when he moves from one part of the land to another, that he does it with speed. The Prophet ﷺ said, it is not done with speed, and this is not piety. Done too quickly, you could harm other people. Done too quickly, you can cause congestion. And for us, this has an added meaning. If you move too quickly, not only are you harming other people and you are going against the command of the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, but you are breaking the laws of the country that you live in when you move and transport yourself on earth. And the Prophet ﷺ said during that Hajj, if there is a chance for you to move forward with ease and haste, then do so. But if that option is not available for you, then do not do so, because you will harm other people and you can congest the walkways. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet ﷺ also said in another hadith, the good we spread on the roads and the pavements, or even the harm that we cause on the roads and the pavements, is actually connected to our belief in our Lord. The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Iman bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah, that Iman is 70 odd branches. فَأَفْضَلُهَا قَوْلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, the highest and the best of them is to say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. وَأَدْنَاهَا, the lowest form of Iman is an action that the Prophet ﷺ said, إِمَاتَةُ الْأَذَى عَنِ الطَّرِيقِ, is to remove any kind of harm from the pathway, is to remove harm from any kind of harm that is being caused on the pathway, and this is part of Iman. So how can he be part of Iman when he himself is the harm? He also said in another hadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اتقوا اللعانين, fear the two curses upon you. So the companions asked, what are these two curses upon us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الذي يتخلى في الطريق الناس أو في ذلهم. He then relieves himself in the path of the people or in their shadows. The Prophet ﷺ is saying in the second hadith that there are people who create litter, there are people who create harm, there are people who block pathways, there are people who do not move from one place to another in an appropriate manner. And all of this is a deficiency in that person's iman. And he could even then fall under a curse that the Prophet ﷺ has warned about. So our speed, the way we walk, the way we drive, the way we park our cars, even where we park our cars, the Prophet ﷺ is telling us to think about giving people their rights. And this is connected to a person's iman. And if your iman is strong, look at the result, my brothers and sisters. The Prophet ﷺ said in another hadith, بَيْنَمَا رَجُلٌ يَمْشِي بِالطَّرِيقِ, there was a man once, he was walking from Bani Israel, and he was just walking on the pavement. He wasn't thinking about Allah, he was not worshipping Allah at all, he was just walking on the pavement. وَجَدَ غُسْنَ شَوْكٍ عَلَىٰ طَرِيقٍ فَأَخَذَهُ, he saw a thorn on the pathway. He saw a thorn, something harmful on the road. So he removed it. The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah loved that action so much. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ فَغَفَرَ لَهُ, Allah thanked him. Allah was pleased with his action, so he forgave him of all of his sins. This is how perfect our religion is, my brothers and sisters. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, rahimahullah, said, this is because Islam has a well-known principle, and that principle is, la darara wa la dirar. Anything which is going to stop something from benefiting, anything where a person places as a barrier between that person and goodness, is not allowed. Or anything which is actually going to harm somebody else, is not allowed. Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, rahimahullah, is saying that this is a well-known principle in Islam, that we are not allowed to spread harm or stop any kind of path that is leading towards any kind of goodness. All of this is haram in our perfect religion. My brothers and sisters, may Allah protect us. In the Quran even, we find some of the harshest punishments that were revealed connected to those people who corrupted the roads and the highways. So in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, some people used to sit by the road. Some people used to be highway robbers. Some people used to kidnap other people. And the Quran addressed this also, because they were spreading corruption in the highways. And Allah says about them, ذَلِكَ لَهُمْ خِزْيٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا, they have a humiliation in the life of this dunya. وَلَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ عَذِيمٌ, and in the akhirah, a severe torment and punishment. We find also in the Quran, my brothers and sisters, may Allah make this as our guide, that the sign of earth becoming corrupt a sign of earth becoming a place of fitna, a sign that earth is going to be even more oppressive, is when people use the roads in a manner that is not supposed to be used for. But a sign of iman, my brothers and sisters, is found in the way we walk, the reason that we walk for, and the laws that we abide by, because the people of iman are good in their behavior, and they want good for all of creation. And for them is a promise of Jannah. جَنَّاتُ عَدْنِ يَدْخُلُونَهَا وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ فَنِعْمَ عُقْبَى الدَّارِ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after those people who had iman, and for them and their family members and their parents and their children, angels will walk into them saying salam. But in the very next ayah, وَالَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدُ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ, those who rejected the religion of Allah and its laws, and they neglected them. وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلُ, and they cut off any kind of connection to what Allah has made obligatory. وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and they spread corruption on the land of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةُ, and for them is a curse and a punishment. وَلَهُمْ سُوءُ الدَّارِ. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن والسنة أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. استغفر الله. الحمد لله, الحمد لله على إحسانه, والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه, وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله داعيا إلى رضوانه الهادي إلى إحسانه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my brothers and sisters, the ulama have mentioned that part of giving thanks to Allah, part of being thankful and doing shukr to Allah, is that a person expresses all appreciation to Allah internally and externally. So he recognizes the favors of Allah and he ponders upon them. And then he talks about them. Because when he talks about them, he is describing to Allah, he's describing to others about the grace of Allah upon them, and the grace and the favors that their master has bestowed them with in this life of the dunya. But also part of shukr, my brothers and sisters, is that a person must use the things that they have been given as a favor in a proper manner. So if Allah has given you a nice car, if Allah has given you a nice bike, or the greatest ni'mah, Allah has given you two fully functioning legs that carry you, and you are able to walk, then give thanks to Allah by remembering those favors and using them properly. Because the ulama have mentioned the only way that you can give thanks to Allah is to use what He has given you as a favor in a proper manner. And if you don't use it in a proper manner, it's actually a sign of ungratefulness towards the Creator. Allah says in the Quran, اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم جاره. Anybody who believes in Allah on the last day, then they should honor their neighbor. And in another narration, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلْيُحْسِنْ إِلَىٰ جَارِهِ, then he should be good towards his neighbor. So how can a person be thankful to Allah when you are being mean towards your neighbor? How can a person be thankful to Allah when he's not considering the needs of his neighbor and the people in his community? When people are blocking the pathway, when you take his space on purpose. And in the masjid, my brothers and sisters, in the masjid also we have neighbors, and they have complained previously. The neighbors of this masjid, the house of Allah, have complained about the people who come to the house of Allah. And they have complained again recently. The factories are saying that people are coming to the masjid to worship Allah, and they are blocking their deliveries. They are creating corruption on the earth. This is what they are saying about us. Whilst they are trying to come to the masjid to say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Is there a contradiction in Islam? People are saying, my brothers and sisters, that they can't even walk. So we are not even talking about our neighbors anymore. We are talking about people coming to the masjid to worship Allah. They are saying they can't even walk on the pavement because people have parked in an irresponsible manner. Sometimes on double yellow lines, and sometimes on the pavement itself. And in the Thursday that just went by, somebody blocked off half of the road, creating danger for road users because he wanted to pray Salatul Asr. So for more than 10, 15 minutes, people using the road were at risk. People couldn't even make a safe turn into St. Saviour's Road. That's because he wanted to be a worshipper to visit the house of Allah. My brothers and sisters, the council have allocated places for us to park. And it's not permitted to park in a place where you're not allowed to park. Islamically, that is haram. You are not allowed to leave your car there unless if there is an absolute necessity. Unless there is an absolute necessity, it becomes haram for a person to park his car there. Because this is causing harm towards other people, and it's causing harm towards other people using their cars. And it is actually even causing harm to the elderly and the weak and young children. And the Prophet ﷺ also said in this hadith, if you believe in Allah on the last day, do not cause harm to those people in your community and to your neighbors. So my brothers and sisters, think about the way you drive. Think about whether you're wearing your seatbelts correctly. Think about whether you're abiding by the law. And if you don't find parking, then the option is easy. Leave early. Park slightly far away if you have to. But think about where you are going and for the purpose that you're going for, because this is the characteristic of those who Allah praises in the Quran. The Prophet ﷺ said, "A'tu at-tariq haqqaha." Give the roads, give the pathways their right. So the companions asked, how can we give right to the road and the pavements? They are blocked concrete. The Prophet ﷺ said, your understanding is wrong. He said, "Ghaddul basar," when you're walking on the land, lower your gaze. "Wa kafful adha," when you're walking on the land and you're parking your cars, do not cause harm to one another. "Wa raddus salam," respond to the greeting of Islam and spread the salam. "Wa amrun bil ma'roof," enjoying what you see, which is good, on the pathways. "Wa nahyun anil munkar," and forbid anything that is happening which is against the law. Forbid anything that is happening which is going to cause harm to other people. My brothers and sisters, if a person has iman, he will be concerned. But if a person, his iman is weak, or he thinks himself to be safe, then nothing will change him. But if we continue in this state, Allah says the world will become corrupted because of the way that people use their pathways, and nothing will remain for our children and the future generations. Ibadallah, إن الله أمركم بأمر كريم. قال تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر دينك وعبادك المؤمنين. اللهم أصلح بيوتنا وأصلح أولادنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أصلح بيوتنا ومجتمعاتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان يا قوي يا جبار. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والإسيان. اللهم اجعلنا من الراشدين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا وعاف مبتلانا وارحم ضعفنا واجبر كسرتنا بقوتك يا جبار يا عزيز. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم، ولذكر الله اكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.